Hey my loves, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Amy. For today's video, we are gonna discuss Christian Dior. This is a long list. I just love a lot of these things from the fashion house. Like I said before, and if you know my collection and if you've been following my channel, I'm heavily into Chanel at the moment. I love Louis Vuitton, but Dior is just one of those brands where I haven't really dipped my toes in as much yet. I have a few pieces of costume jewelry, but that's about it. So let's dive into the world of Dior. I'm gonna start off with bags, and of course the most classic and timeless one is the Lady Dior, and there's a lot of Lady Dior that I like. I wrote down the Lady Dior medium gray stone and the Lady Delight in the embroidered canage fabric. It's such a beautiful new release from this year. I don't know if they're seasonal. I don't know enough about Dior to know. Maybe you can let me know down below. I also really like the patent leather. I am open to the medium size, but I think I would either go with the patent or this new fabric, which is really interesting. They're both the same price range on the US website anyway. They're both $44.50, which is really expensive because that's in US dollars, and our exchange rate right now, it's terrible. Otherwise, I think any of the ABC Dior are lovely. I'm not as big of a fan of the thicker strap, to be honest, but I guess I don't really own the bag, so I don't know for sure. This size just looks like the perfect in-between size. Ideally, I like the mini size more just because it looks so cute and I love the chain detail, but I hear a lot of you tell me that it's not that practical, so I'm kind of 50-50 on either of them. I guess if I were to get that one, it would be in lambskin, so it won't be an everyday bag anyway. So the next bag that I wrote down is the Trente Montaigne. Surprise, surprise. I love the Trente Montaigne ever since it came out. I love it in both the oblique fabric, which is their canvas, or even the leather. I think the smooth leather looks amazing in the black color against the gold. They kept increasing their prices, especially for all the oblique fabric, which is their more popular line, I suppose. That's why they kept increasing to the point where it's almost the same price as leather. So it's like, what do you choose? Leather is more expensive and more classic looking, but the fabric just looks so cool and relevant. I also like the little box bag. The little box bag, I actually had a chance to try it on, and it fits my phone, it fits my clay. I think it fits a card holder and maybe a lipstick, a lip product. And that's all I need on a regular basis, to be very honest, at the very, very minimal, obviously. So it's a very, very tiny bag. It's almost very novelty, especially in black with the CD in front. It's just so classic looking. I think you can wear it multiple ways, especially as a clutch as well. So I'm very, very intrigued by that one. I think it boils down to whether I get the regular Trente Montaigne bag or the box bag, because unless I add both of them, I really have to choose between the two. The last bag that I want to mention before we go into accessories and ready to wear is the book tote, of course. I have my reservations about it, but I do like the look of it. I really like both sides, actually. The larger size looks amazing in their regular oblique fabric, just classic blue. Not as much of a fan of the burgundy color, but I do like the blue a lot. So if I went with the larger size, I would just go classic blue oblique. But if I went with the small size, there's so many more choices that I would rather get the small size in. I feel like because it's a smaller size, I don't mind if it's more colorful or if it has more, like, you know, different designs on it. I'm a huge fan of the toile de Juif with the beautiful tiger embroidery on it. I'm also a fan of the houndstooth, just simple, very classic print. The pièce de résistance in terms of the small size book tote would be the beautiful multicolor pattern. One of the ready-to-wear items that I think I would love to get is the bar jacket. I'm wearing my Balmain jacket right now with my Balmain t-shirt, but it's not the same. I feel like with Balmain, it's such a structured look. It has a signature look. You can definitely tell from afar that you're wearing Balmain. With the bar jacket, it just looks so feminine, whereas this one looks a lot more edgy and just almost a lot more masculine in a way. With the bar jacket, it looks very feminine. It looks very, it just looks very dressy. It's very nice. Like, the vibe is totally different. I definitely would feel like more of a Dior girl if I owned a bar jacket. Wool and silk version that's double-breasted, $4,600. It's still expensive because it is in US dollars, but I thought it would be 8,000 or something. The single-breasted one is 4,100, the tweed one is 4,400, and then there's also a three-quarter sleeve one, which also looks lovely, is 3,900. So it's a lot more reasonable than I ever thought. I also wrote down their black matte tulle skirt. It's one of those signature Dior look, which is why I'm still open to, you know, in the ideal dreamy world I would own it as well, and that is $3,300. And I thought it was, you know, it's expensive obviously, but it's one of those things where you're like, oh, I just want to own one, you know. It's usually I'm not a skirt girl, like I'd rather wear dresses, but with this skirt I just can't get my eyes off it. Of course, if I get the skirt, then I would have to get at least a couple of t-shirts, right? I don't really like all their other logo, like slogan t-shirts with all the, you know, different feminism slogans. Nothing against it, obviously, but I just like their plain Jadzia number 8 t-shirt. I think it's the most classic. I don't even mind the logo of that. I think it's pretty versatile. You can wear it underneath any sort of jacket. Even though I'm not super into logo t-shirts anymore, I'm still really attracted to that one. I just feel like that t-shirt can be dressed down or dressed up, especially with the tulle skirt and their bar jacket. I think it's the whole ensemble. Beautiful belts that I love from the fashion house is the Dior Quake. You can wear that belt with other brand of clothing as well, and I don't feel like it kind of clashes that much. So I'm a big fan of that belt. In fact, I like it a lot more than the Gucci belt. I like it a lot more than the LV belt, possibly more than the Chanel belt even. So yeah, in terms of like a basic black belt with a buckle, with the hardware buckle, I really like the Dior one. I think it's beautiful. That one is $740 for the smaller size, but the size up is $990. Pretty standard pricing for a luxury belt. Every time I see anybody unbox like a big nice throw from Dior, it just looks so luxurious. It just feels like, of all the different brands out there, I just really, really am drawn to the ones that are made by the house of Dior. I just really like it. I feel like they are classic enough to pair on my plain coats, so I'm a big fan. I'm gonna finish off with some jewelry. One of the costume jewelry that I really have my eye on are not earrings, because I will no longer be buying Dior earrings. I really like the choker pearl necklace that they have. It looks lovely on so many influencers that I saw it on. I've really been into pearls lately. I don't have a pearl choker, so I feel like the Dior choker, pearl choker looks really nice, and it's actually not too badly priced. It's $730. It's still expensive, but it's one of those items where you see it, you're like, wow, it's so beautiful. I never realized that fine jewelry from Dior and even Chanel are actually, they're not as bad as I thought. I thought they would be like astronomically expensive, which they are, depending on what you choose, I suppose. But if you choose the pieces that are more entry level, I guess, if you want to call it that, or just the more simple, more like well-priced pieces, they look really good, and the price is not really that bad, because if you compare a completely man-made costume choker that is $500 to $700, you might as well add a little bit more to get fine jewelry, right? There is this one that's called Rose des Vents, 18 karat pink gold necklace, mother of pearl or onyx with diamond, and it's about $2,000, and it is at least solid gold, right? It is 18 karat gold. Obviously, with fine jewelry, it tends to be more like everyday pieces, so the usage of them is a little different. With costume jewelry, you can have a lot more fun with them, but I just feel like sometimes you can take a break from costume jewelry and then invest your money in fine jewelry pieces that you don't have to take off every single time you shower, every single time you go to the pool. You know, you can likely just kind of wear them and wipe them off, if you will, if you are really worried about ruining them. And then of course the matching bracelet at around the same price, $1,850, also looks amazing. It's just one of those designs with the star inside, very, very Dior heritage. because Christian Dior himself is into astrology. But aside from their bags, I'm surprised that I like so many more things from the fashion house than I ever thought, because as I was browsing the site and I'm like, wow, I'm adding actually a really long list of things. I thought I would only have like three bags that I was gonna talk about, but no, I like the belt, I like the bar jacket, I like the tulle skirt, I like the t-shirt, and I even like their fine jewelry. So it's very interesting, the moment that you start digging in more. Like I said on my wishlist video, I was hoping that this year would be my year of Dior, but with all the stores closing and this pandemic, we shall see, because right now we're just in limbo, we don't know, which is fine because it gives me a chance to research more and to talk about these things with you on a video like this, and we can all discuss what you think about my choices, what about your experience with some of the other items from the fashion house other than bags, because in the past I've always just talked about bags, but the more I browse, the more I find out that I like a lot of their things actually. So anyway, I hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please comment down below what your thoughts are and then what you recommend as well in addition to these. Maybe I missed something. And I hope that you guys are doing well. Have a great day or week ahead of you. If you're brand new, please don't forget to subscribe. I love you guys and I'll talk to you guys again very soon. Bye!